first put into development during the Uprising War, as a response to conglomerate forces using warp gates as choke points and kill boxes, making a sailing through the gates a dangerous task, with an almost certainty of a high casualty rate. The Hukarn sovereignty pulled together what resources they had to construct the Dirichlet-class cruiser, with the idea in mind that it was going to be a simple battering ram against gate blockades, with layered shielding, heavy armor, and plentiful forward-focused weaponry. It could not be stopped against conventional fleet tactics, even against several of the conglomerate's frigates, would not be able to slow it down. With a width of 265 meters, a length of 573 meters, and a height of 119 meters, the majority of the ship's inner mass is concentrated on energy production, heat management, and weaponry targeting computers for its collection of purpose-selected weaponry. Surprisingly, because of the Dirichlet's complete lack of any laser point defense systems, more space was allocated to other areas of the ship, such as more robust heat sinks, and finally, decent crew quarters and amenities for its 500 crew members and 100 marines. With more modern Dirichlet cruisers being retrofitted with new artificial gravity plating, to ensure some usefulness outside of the Dirichlet's role as a blockade breaker, the cruiser is equipped with 28 large torpedo launchers and 12 nuclear torpedoes. Both are very capable of destroying groups of ships, tear apart any space installations, or engulf a small continent of a planet with a 120 megaton explosion of nuclear fire. The Dirichlet's main armaments are its railgun turrets, with 12 1,000mm light railgun turrets positioned along the craft for the most effective angle of fire, in the front and to the broadsides, and with the extensive turret targeting systems on board the cruiser, it can aim and fire at multiple targets at once, or focus on certain areas on a single craft. The cruiser is also equipped with four of the newer 2,000mm dual railgun turrets, which offer a heavier impact at similar rate of fire, but it has a slower traverse rate and lower accuracy than the lighter turrets. Lastly are the pair of large 750kW spinal laser cannons, used to clear the way in front of the Dirichlet class, as it barrels through the warp gate to clear the enemy forces on the other side, providing an opening for allied forces to follow behind while the enemy blockade is in disarray. The Dirichlet class cruiser only saw a limited production run, with only three ever produced during the Uprising War of 228 WS, with only two surviving at the war's end. Afterwards, newer Dirichlet classes would be produced with shared technology from the reparation agreement, and with aid from the newly established League Engineering Corp. The Hukarn sovereignty was able to produce several dozen more of the Dirichlet cruisers, but without a war, and being deemed unfit for general peacetime patrols, many of the class were kept in storage, or used as training grounds for new crew members of the growing United Zonix League Navy. The rest of the cruisers are often now used as military promotional material, museum ships, or as a centerpiece in parades, celebrating the end of the Uprising War each year. Many of the Hukarn sovereignty citizens voiced their concerns about building and maintaining the cruisers during peacetime, given that their role was an offensive one, but as was an insurance policy by the sovereignty's government and military higher-ups, in preparation to signs of a potential Terran Republic invasion, as their territory borders are closest to the Republic. They would hope to be a defensive wall for the rest of the League while they rallied their forces for retaliation. Despite all their preparations, however, they failed in modernizing their navy and could not have predicted the new technologies that the Republic would have created for the invasion, or rather, what the Republic Covert Security Agency would have created, as unseen stealth ships with onboard warp gates simply bypassed all of the sovereignty's defenses, causing mass panic and destruction on unprotected League worlds. Like and subscribe for more from the archives.